Oh my gosh. Oh, no, no, no. No, no, no. You guys, stop, 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 stop. Basil, oh. Oh my God. There was a bunny in that pumpkin. And I startled it, and then I was so scared the dogs were gonna catch it.
I don't know if I'm supposed to be this excited. I'm really excited. I've wanted a chicken coop for like, my whole life. What up, guys? I'm back and I'm excited to be back. During lockdown, I became a farmer. I always felt like I didn't have enough skills or I didn't know, and it was something I wanted to do, but I felt like I needed all these things. I just kind of came outside and started digging. And I had a lot of random like pieces of concrete that were these planters that were kind of dilapidated, and then stone kind of deep in the ground. So I just got in, weeded, pulled everything out, separated everything, made piles, and then kind of was able to use it. I love paint, and I love organization, and I love styling because it's instant gratification. Gardening is the exact opposite. You have to start, but then it's amazing how fast things grow, and I feel so trite and so obvious, but I'm looking at my tomato plant, I'm looking at my pumpkins, and they just grow. It's a major work in progress, but the good news is I'm progressing and I can finally share some of that progress with you. This video is sponsored by Sherwin Williams. I just love their products so much. I love the variety. I like that I have so many different colors to choose from. I always use their Emerald line, which is their high-end line, just because I think it's such a good paint. And when you compare it with other high-end price points of paint, it's a really good price point for the quality you get. So the paint I used is Emerald Rain Refresh. And what's great about it is literally rain refresh. It cleans itself off, it's self-cleaning with the rain, with the hose, it's UV safe. It's just amazing, and I figure like, it's a chicken coop, it's dirty. I live like in the dirt and dust and everything. It's beautiful, but it's dirty. So I used Dover White because I wanted it to match my house. And I used iron ore, which I've been wanting to use for a while, and it's a dark charcoal, and it can read as black, but it's just slightly softer than black. First thing, I had to put the chicken coop together. It looked really easy. I knew I could do it myself, but those directions were crazy. They were like universal instructions that don't really work well for anyone. And at first I was really intimidated because I was trying to match up the screws, which were really hard to be labeled. And then I was also trying to do it by myself, so like trying to angle and hold it together was basically impossible.
I wouldn't say there's a lot of instructions, but it looks pretty easy. We'll see.
So basically I've concluded two things. One, I can't put this together by myself because I can't hold it flat and in the right place and screw drive it at the same time or screw it in. And I think it would be better to paint before I put it together. So I'm starting out with multi-purpose latex primer. I actually used this in the shed as well. Well, I double primed in the shed, but this is one of the ones I use and it works super well. So this is starting out with this. Primer was recommended. I had a feeling. So I got my mom to come help me because I needed help. Oh my God, let me see it. Let me see it. Oh, it's so cute. It's so cute. This tray though.
I will show you what's cute. This.
Oh yeah, there's two of them. Each side. This drill though. You got it for me for Christmas.
Yep.
Pretty much put it together. The roof isn't totally attached, but it's like ready to go. Now I'm gonna paint the outside. It's been so incredibly hot. I can't even tell you guys, triple digits. So waited till a little bit more in the evening to finish painting. I'm using Dover White. So I'm excited about that because I think it'll match the house really well. Plus I have this shed here that's this green color with white trim, and I just think that will be really cute together. So yeah, so I'm excited because it's like, I'm looking at it right now. It's cute. Okay. Do-do-do.
Okay, so I woke up super early to get some stuff done before it gets hot. So I'm gonna drag this coop back. I keep wanting to call it house. Doesn't it feel like a little chicken house? Anyway, I'm gonna pull that back there now. And then I'm gonna add the roof. I feel like I made some good progress painting last night. So hopefully, I don't know. And it might not be flat back there. That's another thing. So I gotta work that out. But I've been softening up the soil a little bit. So I think it should be a little bit easier. Had two posts in the ground with concrete, and they were just left from an old fence. And basically they extended the fence, I don't know, what is that, 6 feet or something, and they left those two posts. And so I was able to really reuse them. And that's also what I'm really happy about with this, is it's not 100% reused, but there's a ton of stuff I reused and repurposed in here and really tried to make work, and I think it came together in a really cute way. Then I have the roof, which I actually got next door from my next door neighbor, Connie. She had it left over from an old horse shader. So I was able to use that, so that was really exciting. And also what's really cool is the exact number of corrugated metal pieces that she had is the exact number we used. One tip that I saw on Pinterest that I love is they said if you want wire to disappear, the look of it, to paint it black. So I used my iron ore, not quite black, to go over it, especially where it was layered, and it really made a huge difference. And what it does is the metal reflects the light, so it shines and you see it. As soon as you paint it dark, you don't see it anymore. The light doesn't bounce off of it, and the illusion of just like seeing through it and not have that light bounce back makes a massive difference. So that's a good tip for you guys if you ever need it. I also had a pile of extra concrete pieces, so I made my little concrete wall, which I love and worked perfectly, and I had a pile more, and I thought, what am I gonna do with these? Like, I don't know where to throw them away. It's a whole thing. So I decided that like I would just slowly kind of reuse things that I had originally found in the yard. So I was able to use the rest of the concrete pieces, and I just made these kind of faux kind of planters, which are really nice. I also knew I wanted like things to vine all over this situation. So I got two climbing roses. I thought it would be really cute to put them by the door. I just think it gives some kind of like prominence to it. And I want it to be like kind of house-like, and as it starts to grow, it'll grow all over that chicken wire and it will be amazing. And maybe I'll even do a little arch. We'll see what happens. I feel like I can't lose with climbing roses. And they smell, They're so cute, they're multicolored, and they smell so sweet. And then I got the cutest little grapevine. When I got it, I just had to have her. I went into the nursery, my little local hardware store, and she was grabbed onto three different parts. Well, three different vines were grabbed onto different things around it, and I literally had to unwind it. And I thought, she's so happy, she just wants to grill and climb. So I put her on the end, and the grapes will grow around, and the chickens like that. I'm gonna probably plant more around here, so now I have like a garden area. So I wanted kind of a farmhouse look, but I wanted it to go with the house, and I wanted it all to blend, and now I feel like it looks like it's always been there. I'm so excited. Can you tell? So more backyard progress to come, more fallness coming, and how cute are my pumpkins though? But for real, how cute are my pumpkins though? That was a tiny little plant. At the nursery it said plant before 4th of July for Halloween pumpkins, and I've got them, so that's exciting. My first ever. I gotta give everyone a little pumpkin, all my neighbors. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you love this video as much as I do. I feel like it's a really good transformation. Thank you, Sherwin Williams, for sponsoring this as always, because you guys are fabulous and I love working with you. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.